Hola amigos, soy Benito Lucio para Hispano TV y es un placer para presentarles un amigo aquí en Columbus, Ohio, que es author y también performer. Y me estaba contando recientemente que también es un filmmaker. Se llama Javier Sánchez, una persona muy conocida aquí en Columbus por el esfuerzo que hace con los jóvenes y una persona que también nacionalmente es una persona muy reconocida por su trabajo con los jóvenes. Javier, welcome to Hispano TV, and quite an honor. I know that you've dedicated a lot of time to youth, and tell us about yourself and the projects that you have going, and then we'll talk about your presentation.
Absolutely, yeah. It's great to be here, first of all. I'm so excited about being home, and that's something I don't get to say too often, is I'm home. Like you said, I get to travel around the world using my art to influence people in a positive way. And so a friend of mine, a co-creator of my latest book called From This Moment On, he calls it what we do as being art-fluential, using our art to influence others in a positive way. And so, yeah, I get to travel around the world performing, entertaining, and moving youth and adults from inspiration to action, and I love it. I get to do comedy and spoken word poetry and hip hop, and then now we're making films and having an impact on Hollywood, and so that's exciting too. And I just love it. It's all about impact. It's all about having a positive impact and leaving this planet better than how we found it.
Javier, today's youth. Mm-hmm. What is the biggest challenge that they face in society? I know that you see all the negative.
Yeah, yeah.
But what are you seeing out there, and what works? What works for the young people that encourages them to be successful?
Yeah, well, you know what? I see. We do tend to see the negative because that's what's promoted and perpetuated in the media and everything, but I see so much positive. In fact, a lot more actually. And what we tend to happen is we magnify what's going wrong, and when you magnify something, you're making it appear bigger than what it really is. And so I love getting out there and getting in schools and getting into communities and seeing the amazing things that young people are doing. But what they're I think struggling with the most, or one of their biggest challenges, is, and not just young people, people period, we want to be happy and we want to be hopeful, you know what I mean? And but when we're so saturated with media and marketing and advertising, because everybody wants to sell somebody something, and one of the prime objectives of an advertiser, I think, is to make you unhappy, make you feel like something's wrong with you. And so that they can fix you. Something's wrong with the way you look. Something's wrong with the way you're dressed, the way you're shaped, the clothes you have on, the shoes you have on. Something's wrong with you because you're not going to see this movie or buying this music. You know, you're not liked, you're not noticed, you're not appreciated, you're not loved, you're broken. We can fix you by buying our stuff. So, I mean, our young people spend in the United States $120 billion every year on food, fashion, health and beauty products, and entertainment. Those four things alone. And so when you, and they see more advertisements in a day than anybody else on the planet. I mean, they are advertised to, they see anywhere from 500 to 5,000 commercials in one day. And that's potentially 500 to 5,000 times a day they're being told something's wrong with them. And so, of course they're gonna be miserable. Of course they're gonna be unhappy. Of course they're gonna be hopeless. And so what we try to do is amplify the positive things and the positive opportunities that they have in their life and try to challenge and encourage them to experience life to the fullest in a healthy, safe, and positive way. And so if we can get them in a place where they know that they can choose to be happy and they can put themselves in a position to be hopeful, then we're doing our job.
Give me an example of, when you're performing, a little taste of what you do to get young people to listen to your message.
Okay, yeah, for sure. Well, I use comedy. I'm a stand-up comedian. I perform in comedy clubs all over the country, and I tell a lot of stories about my life growing up and about, you know, the life I'm living right now as a father, you know, raising two children. And so, like, one of the examples I give, it's important that young people define who they are. I tell them all the time, define yourself, or if you don't define you, someone else will define you for you, and most likely won't be for your benefit. And so, and then I tell a story about when I was trying to help my son define who he was when he was younger. I'm trying to teach him who he is. He ends up teaching me who I am. And so I said to him, you know, and this is a true story, actually. I was like, you know, Mateo, mommy's black and daddy's Mexican. And so you're black and you're Mexican. And he said, I'm not black, I'm brown. I was like, well, you're talking about your skin color. I'm talking about who you are. You know, mommy's black, you're black. He said, mommy's not black. I'm like, what are you talking about, mommy's not black? He said, mommy's light brown. I'm like, no. You're confused. I'm talking about skin color, not, you know, you're talking about something else. I was like, but hold on. I said, if mommy's light brown, what does that make daddy? He said, you're dark white. Right? And so, you know, he ended up teaching me who I was at that point. So, you know, I tell funny stories and jokes, and I do, you know, spoken word poetry. That's my way to engage the audience, to entertain them, so that we can get to the root and the real content and the meat of my message, which is, you know, your past doesn't disqualify you from your future. You have an opportunity to experience life to the fullest, better than, and it starts with the choices you make from this moment on. And, you know, let's be intentional about leaving people better than how you found them.
So the bottom line from what you're telling me is that what's important for young people today is to create an identity for themselves based on who they are. I mean, mm-hmm. And you're looking at the cultural and,
yeah.
and all of that. What role can parents play? You know, I mean, I know you mentioned that, you know, your children taught
yeah,
you,
yeah.
But how crucial is it for parents to be involved in that? Because I also say to people, you know, that when I was young, I had to be a born-again Mexican, you know,
yeah,
because
yeah, yeah.
I really didn't know.
Yeah.
What that really meant,
right,
and where
right.
we came from, and the cultural perspective.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, so I think, you know, I always say to people, it's good to be a born again Mexican and born again Christian, because you have a better perspective of, you know, where you fit into that puzzle
right.
of life. You know,
yeah,
where,
yeah,
where,
yeah.
where you are, and you know, from your perspective, how important is it for the parents to be involved with their children in helping them? Develop their identity, their who they are, and making that a positive experience. I know, because we go through in you know, the peer pressure.
Right.
So, you know, what's your take on that perspective?
Right. A couple of things. Yeah, you're absolutely right. Parents should be very intentional about helping their children create an identity for themselves, and helping them create that definition, because everyone else is trying to define who you are. And if you don't define who you are, if you don't know who you are, you're going to take suggestions from others. You're going to take suggestions from the music you listen to. You're going to take suggestions from the stuff you see on TV, the stuff you see in media, the stuff other people say about you. And so you have to be intentional about help. We have to be intentional about helping our children define who they are. And one of the ways that we kind of mess it up, I don't want that, for lack of a better word, is we ask our children, what do you want to be when you grow up?
Right.
And when, in terms
of
defining who you are.
That's very common.
What do you want to be when you grow up? Well, I don't ask my kids that for a couple reasons. One, when you say, what do you want to be when you grow up? It insinuates that you can't be or do anything significant right now. Mm-hmm. Then in order to be or do something significant, you have to be a grown up, an adult, 21 or over. The other problem, in terms of identity, when you say, what do you want to be when you grow up? The only thing we equate that with is how to earn an income, how to earn money, you know, and that's not your entire identity, how you earn money. You know, I don't care what you want to do for a living. I want to know what you're doing for a life. So I change the question for my kids. I ask my kids, who and what are you becoming right now in terms of your attitude, in terms of your actions, in terms of your aspirations? What are you becoming more of? What are you becoming better at? What do you want to become more of? What do you want to become better at? What are you aspiring to become? You know, what is your dream job?
Right.
And then Once I know what they want to become more of, what they want to become better at, what they're aspiring to become, now I can be their ally and their advocate and kind of create that world for them and kind of give them some help along the way.
The connection.
Right. Yeah. And parents think we've lost our power, but we really haven't, you know. We did a survey, a national survey, for parents and young people. One of the questions on the survey we asked was we asked young people, who has the biggest influence on you? And the options were parents, friends, music, media, you know, all these different options. And then we asked the parents who they thought had the biggest influence on their children. Mm-hmm. Same thing. Vast majority of the parents said music and friends. The vast majority of the responses from the young people, parents.
Parents, yeah.
They said their parents have the big, but we've given up our power. We've been tricked into believing that we can't influence or impact our children, and it's not true. We can, and we do, and we have a significant impact on our children all the time. And so it's so important that we're intentional about, you know, helping them create that identity.
So, in reality, is helping them build their character.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Their presence in society, mm-hmm. you know, from the little person to the big person, but mm-hmm. You help them build that positive perspective about themselves. And I think that what you also are very strong in what you do is mm-hmm. giving the encouragement, right?
Oh, yeah, cheering them on. We're quick to catch them in the act of doing something wrong. Mm-hmm. You know, we notice that stuff all the time, you know, and I tell when I'm working with parents or adult, any adult that works with young people, you know, I say for some reason at some point we stop being impressed with our young people.
Right.
You know, we cheer them on when they take their first steps or their first words or the first time they go to the bathroom by themselves, whatever. We cheer those things on because they're all these amazing firsts. But then at some point we stop being impressed with them and we stop noticing when they do things right and they do things good. We notice when they fall short. Because what was once the celebrated behavior becomes just the expected behavior. Mm-hmm. And we'll notice it when they fall short of the expected behavior, but if they meet or exceed that expected behavior, it oftentimes goes unnoticed. And so as parents, as teachers, as adults working with young people, we need to notice when they do something right, when they meet or exceed our expectations as well.
Javier, tell us about the work that you do here in Columbus. I know mm-hmm. that you work with the schools and different mm-hmm. programs, but tell us, you know, where can people here in the community, the Latino community, where can they go see Javier Sanchez?
Javier Sanchez. I get to bring my show home. I tour internationally with my show From This Moment On, Say It Loud, Live It Louder. And for the first time ever, I'm bringing my show home to Columbus. And I'm so excited. We're going to be performing here at the Shedd Theater, the Columbus Performing Arts Center. And so I'm really excited about that. But I also get to work with a really incredible program called Youth to Youth, and which was actually started here in Columbus in 1982. And the program literally saved my life and changed my life. I was a young person growing up in Columbus, right in the middle of the crack epidemic, and got caught up in all that, you know, the drug culture, the gang culture, all those. I got shot when I was in the 10th grade, everything going wrong because I thought I had limited options and opportunities as a young person growing up in the inner city, until I got plugged into this program, Youth to Youth, and they showed me that I could live and rise above my circumstances, and they created options and opportunities outside of the limited ones that I thought people that looked like me or came from where I came from or had the experiences I had had for myself. And so Youth to Youth is still a thriving program. It's an international program. It's in like 37 states and about 17 different countries. Started right here in Franklin County in 1982, and it's still here.
They have a website?
Yeah, youthtoyouth.net. Yeah, youth, youthtoyouth.net. And I love that I get to, this program that gave so much to me, I get to continue to give back to them. So it's awesome.
I bet it's exciting, uh-huh. you know, that given, you know, all you've experienced in life and to now be in this position to make an impact
mm-hmm.
And make a difference because, you know, it's, you know, the old saying, been there, done that.
Uh-huh.
And so... how do you feel about that? That you've been given this talent, you're using it now, what's been one of the most rewarding experiences so far from your career?
The rewarding experience is that I get to do this. I tell everybody, this what I produce, what I create, what I perform, it doesn't come from me, it comes through me, you know? And so just the privilege, the honor of being a vessel that this art and this impact and this influence is coming through is it just blows my mind. You know, I think about, you know, I wrote a book for fathers to read to their daughters called Look in My Mirror. Every page is a father and a daughter looking in the mirror together, and the father telling the daughter what he sees in her reflection, her identity, you know, how intelligent she is and creative she is and beautiful she is and responsible and talented. And that book has changed thousands of lives. You know, I travel the country and you know, people are coming to me and saying, thank you, thank you, thank you. And I'm telling them, don't thank me. There's someone else you can thank, but it's not me, because I was just a vessel that book came through. It didn't come from me, it came through me. The same with the book that we just wrote, me and Marshall Shorts, the co-creator of our newest book, From This Moment On. The book didn't come from me, it came through me. We're having this show here at the Shed Theater. The show and everything that I perform is not coming from me, it's coming through me, and it's just a privilege, and it's very humbling to have something so powerful come through me. The message that I give to Latino youth and any youth is you are not disqualified. And we hear the opposite of that all the time. Because of the color of your skin, you're disqualified. Because of your ethnic heritage, you're disqualified. Because of your paperwork or documents, you're disqualified, or lack thereof, paperwork or documents, you are disqualified. You are not disqualified. Because when you feel like you're disqualified, you give up and you don't make an effort, you don't try. And what I've learned is that my past does not disqualify me from my future. My color, my skin color, my ethnic heritage, it does not disqualify me. And that's what if I could get Latino youth to believe that and start working that out in their life, and we'll see significant change for the better.
Great. Mm-hmm. Javier, te agradezco. I really thank you. I'm excited that we can work with you.
Yes.
and in the future.
Right.
Let's do an event for the Latino community. Bring you and bring our youth and hear your message.
Okay.
Thank you.
Let's do it.
Bueno, amigos, le agradecemos mucho a Javier Sánchez por esta entrevista. Hispano TV, el futuro de nuestra comunidad latina aquí en Columbus es de poder compartir toda esta información de eventos, de personalidades que están haciendo una diferencia en nuestra comunidad para ayudar, para que nuestros jóvenes, para que nuestras familias salgan adelante. Hispano TV, esa es una de las metas de nosotros aquí, es de ayudar en ese esfuerzo en nuestra comunidad. Para Hispano TV, soy Benito Lucio. Muchas gracias.